Hello everybody, I'm Nick, and in the previous video I showed you how you can fix the database performance issues that you might have had by using a caching mechanism on the browser. And I do understand that this is not an approach that everyone can use because, as many of you said in the comments below, you don't necessarily expose APIs to the browser, but APIs for other services to consume. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can greatly improve the performance of your API integration requests and have a very similar experience with what we had before, but this time not the browser, but actually using HTTP client. So let me just remind you what I have here. I have a database running, and this time I have 2 million records of users in my database. This is all just to show you the API we will be calling this time. And this time around, I actually added an index on the username because we're doing a partial search on the username. And you said, Nick, if you had like an index, performance would be insane. It wouldn't. Even in the previous video, 200 milliseconds would be the fastest you would get, down from 890 or 900 milliseconds. So you would still have a slow request no matter what. Databases can only get as fast even with indexes. Now, this API, I'm going to very quickly run it. Just to remind you, and I'm going to run the website as well. It's a Blazor website, so I'm just going to quickly run it to show you. And if I go back here in Firefox, if I refresh this page, as you're going to see, even with the index, the same request as before is 214 milliseconds. And if I refresh now, because I'm using Delta, that library that I showed in the previous video, again, check it out, but I'm going to briefly mention it as well. If I refresh now, this 200 request over here, if I refresh, will become a 304 because the value hasn't changed in the time where I did my refreshes. So this request is now cached on the browser, and every time I refresh, it's going to be extremely fast because we only make a very efficient request now to the database to see if the values have changed. If I was to go here in the data and I change any value, so this is now a different value and I update it and I go back to the browser and I refresh, then that takes 200 milliseconds again. And if I refresh, it goes down to 2 and so on. So this is the experience we had, and we want to have the exact same thing from an API consumer standpoint, because in case you don't know, Dometrain is using a SaaS product in the backend, and a lot of the functionality we do, like granting access to courses and so on, is integrating with that API, which is very fast, but it is not millisecond fast. It just can't be. But they do expose appropriate caching headers, so we can know if the data of that user has changed, and we can know when to cache something or not. In fact, if you're watching this video on the date released, today is the last day you can use the Black Friday 24 discount code to get 40% off anything, that is courses, discounted bundles, or Dometrain Pro, link in the description. So what I want to do now is I'm just going to stop everything, and I want to go to this consumer I've built. So this consumer does the exact same thing that the website does, but we do it through an HTTP client. You might be using code like this. Now, you could be using the HTTP client factory to do this, to generate new clients and so on. What I'll show in this video works with both approaches, but this is a very simple approach where if I'm running the API in the background and I run this consumer over here, what you're going to see is this request taking the first request 543 milliseconds because of that startup overhead, and then around 200 milliseconds per request. Now, this is pretty slow. I mean, it's fast in the grand scheme of things because we do have 2 million records and we are doing a pretty complex query over here. Just to remind you what's going on in the user service, we're calling the database here, doing a partial search on like on the username. So it's not ideal, but there's many cases where in your APIs you might have inefficient queries that they can only be optimized that much. So how can I make this practically perform with like less than a millisecond response? Now, on the API itself, I have Delta installed. It's the package I showed in the other video, which effectively what it's doing is it's adding no cache and e-tag headers on the response. In fact, if I run the website once more, just to show you what's going on here, I'll go back on Firefox, and if I refresh this page, the reason why this is a 304 request is because if I click on this, the browser has recognized that the cache control is no cache and that the e-tag, the value that the server is returning, is this. And as long as this is not changing, the browser says, oh, this is safe for me to cache. And only if I see a difference between what I have cached locally and what the server is returning, only then I'm getting fresh data from that request and I can clear it from the cache. That's basically it. You can even see it in the if none match headers over here of that request. So pretty self-explanatory. I want to have the exact same experience now, but on this consumer. How do I do this? Well, it's another package by Simon Krop. And that NuGet package is called Replicant. So if you search for Replicant, this is the NuGet package. You go ahead and you install it. And what Replicant is doing is it can basically wrap the HTTP client by simply replacing the client with HTTP cache over here. I can say default and just use the default one and then use that here. So the logic would be, in this case, I don't have get async, but I can say response async. And the rest of my code is the same because this is still an HTTP response message. So I can leave this as it is over here. And then once I do that, the same request that took 200 milliseconds to run, if I go and I say run the API in the background and now run this consumer over here. So I'm going to go and just press run. The first request still takes this 582 milliseconds. However, the rest of the requests take less than a millisecond. In fact, we go down to 1/3 of a millisecond. And if I run this again and again and again, you're going to get extremely good performance consistently. Why is that? Well, because the HTTP cache package, the Replicant package, is using the same etag logic and cache control logic now through the HTTP client. So you have the exact same rules. It's going to check for no cache headers, for if match and all that, etags as well. And it's going to use all that in its logic. And I can customize the directory that the cache is stored in. So I can say this directory and then cache. And by the way, you can also customize the HTTP client in any way that you want. So you can return a custom client and you can say maximum amount of entries as well. So you can cache n amount of entries so you don't have to cache everything. But if I just leave it as it is and then I rerun the consumer, I'm going to get this cache folder here now locally. And if I go in this directory, what you're going to see is a bunch of cached requests over here. Now, this JSON object, if I just pull it here, has the instructions with like the etag and everything of the request itself. And then the bin is what contains the actual JSON that was the response that I got originally. And it's just JSON basically. So it's serialized, deserialized, and then returned as if that request was made. But because of that cache control entry now, you don't have to go and make that call to the API. You can get it from the cache and return it. And by the way, this is an open source package. I highly recommend you check the link in the description and you give it a star on GitHub. Excellent, excellent NuGet package again. And you can see all the headers and responses that are respected in caching decisions. So any expires header that you might have, max age, no control, no cache, last modified, etags, any of these can work. And you don't have to implement Delta on your API. This is just an example to show you what's going on here. Any API you're using, if you use the GitHub API over here to get Nick Chaps as the user, if you go in the network tab and you actually do it again, you see you get a 304 because the browser has cached. They're smart enough to cache this request. And if I go over here, you'll see we have things like the etag for this object, last modified. All of these things will be respected. And my HTTP client now knows not to go and get that new version because nothing has changed on that request. So you can combine it with many, many things, including the API I'm using for dome training, which is how I improve performance significantly on the requests we're making. So great, great, excellent NuGet package. I'm sure many of you have a use case for this. You can see how you can customize the HTTP client and dispose all that. You can see things like how to integrate it with your dependency injection container, as well as how to use it with the HTTP client factory, which is what you should be using if you're using HTTP client, as well as other things you can do like reading line by line, reading a string, bytes, stream, downloading a file, downloading a stream. All that is supported. Again, it's a package in its infancy, but I think the logic and what you can do with this is amazing and invaluable. And I highly recommend anyone dealing with API integrations to give this one a go. I think you need this to significantly improve the API integration performance for your systems. But now I wonder from you, what do you think about all this? And are you using something else? Because as we can see down here, there are some other solutions like HTTP cache, cache cow, and Monkey Cache. Leave a comment down below and let me know. Well, that's all I have for you for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, keep coding.